You know, Kingfish, I still don't think we're going to have enough equipment.
Oh, Andy, you're making too much out of the thing. Any intelligent person can figure out an income tax.
Yeah, well, what's the first thing we do?
Well, the first thing is last year's income. I got all the figures right here, Andy.
Yeah, well, me and you was in all the deals together, and I guess we made about the same thing.
You know, Andy, after giving this thing a super fishy look, we had a pretty active year.
Oh, yeah. We really knocked our brains out, didn't we? Please see the thing that came.
Well, in January, that was the first month. January, profit nothing. Loss, $1. Then mm-hmm. February come around. Profit nothing. Loss, $2.50.
Yeah.
March, profit nothing. Loss, $3. Then April, profit nothing, lost nothing. Well, Andy, we broke even in April.
Oh, yeah, we're bound to hit one good month.
And then we took our summer vacation. See, that was May, June, July, August, and September.
Oh, yeah, we cut it short that year.
Oh, yeah, we had to hurry back so we could hit the ball in October.
Yeah, well, when did we sell the donut business? That was a good month.
Oh, yeah. Here it is. December. That's the month we really went strong. Profit from sale of business, $700 apiece. Then on top of that, my salary at the Kingfish. Well, I probably had an income of around $2,000 last year.
Yeah, me too. You know, I made some money on that utility stock I had.
Well, Andy, let's hit the thing here. You take a foam and I'll take one. And Dean's income is about the same. We can kind of figure it out together.
Yeah, that's the stuff.
Well, Andy, this is a slide rule.
Yeah, well, what will that rule do that the other one don't do?
Well, it saves you time in figuring. Now, see, for instance, you want to get 2 into 5. Well, according to the old way of figuring, by 2 go into 5 twice and 1 to carry.
Well, how can you save time with that?
Well, with this, you don't carry, Andy. You just slide. And you get there much faster.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Andy, we got to knock this out in a hurry, because it's got to be in the mail before midnight tonight.
Yeah, check.
Well, first, name. Oh, you sign your name right at the top there, Andy. Address. No trouble there.
No, Kingfish, they're making these things simpler all the time.
Oh, yeah, Andy. We ought to knock this thing out in about 10 minutes. City and state. Social security number.
Social security number. What's that, Kingfish? Something new?
Oh, no, Andy. When folks go to work, why, they give them a number.
Oh, like they do in the Army, huh?
Well, I guess that's the general idea. Now, the first big heading is how to figure your tax. Getting anywhere, Andy?
No, I ain't got nowhere since my name and address.
What are you struggling with now?
Well, I'm struggling with number 9 here. See here, it says disregards lines 10, 11, and 12. And copy on line 13 the same figures you entered on lines 6, 7, and 8 or 9.
Well, how'd you handle it?
Well, it says disregard lines 10, 11, and 12. I think about going a step further and disregarding the whole thing.
We got to get on the ball.
Okay.
Now, this thing ain't gonna be no help.
Yeah, get rid of the deadwood.
Now, where was we?
Well, the next thing is exemption. Multiply $600 by number of exemptions claimed in item 1E.
Had trouble with that too, huh?
Yeah, I worked on that an hour. But how can you multiply 600 by 1E? After all, 600's a digit, and E is a vowel. You can't multiply vowels by digits, can you?
Well, Andy, if you can, this is the first year they allowed it. Andy, this thing is driving me crazy. And if I'd known figuring out income tax was going to be this hard, I never would have allowed myself to make no money last year.
Didn't make much.
No. But by trying just a little bit harder, I could have made nothing.
Oh, hi, fellas.
Hi.
What in the world is happening here?
Well, Amos, we're just trying to make out our income tax, and this is as far as I got.
Oh, no. Gee, Andy. With all the problems they got down in Washington, I wouldn't send them a thing like this.
Well, what are we going to do? The thing's got to be in the mail tonight.
Look, I just finished making out mine, and I think I got the knack of it now. I'll be glad to help you if you don't mind.
It's okay with me.
Yeah, and me too. But I don't see how you're going to do it, Amos. Because it would take a Professor Weinstein to figure out that mess.
Clean this desk off here and see if we can get out of here.
Well, there you is, Amos.
Well, that does it, boys. The form is all made out. The check is in here. And the envelope is addressed and stamped. And all you got to do is mail them.
Thanks, Amos. I'll drop them in the post box on my way home.
Yeah, hurry on and get them in the mailbox, Andy, because we don't want to be late with the thing.
Yeah.
Thank you, Amos.
Oh, that's all right, Casey.
I ain't seen you in a long time, Dolly.
Well, Andy, that's your fault.
Well, where are you headed for, honey?
I'm just out for a little fresh air.
Oh, a little fresh air, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you mind if I breathe along with you?
Oh, I know.
Come on, honey. Oh, what a day.
Andrage Brown speaking.
Hello, Andy.
Oh, hello, darling.
How about you and me having lunch today?
Lunch? Why, yes, honey. I'd be glad to have lunch with you today. What time? Oh, about 1 o'clock, huh? Well, where?
At the Lenox Plaza.
Yeah, well, just a minute, honey, while I write it down. I got it, honey. You know, it sure was lucky meeting up with you yesterday, because I really sweet on you, Darlene.
Oh, you probably tell that to all the girls you know, Andy.
Oh, no, honey, you is really different. You're so sweet, so cute, you're so... Well, you're just really different.
Well, I like to believe that, Andy. Maybe you really are serious.
Oh, sure I am. Even now, whilst I'm sitting here talking to you, I can feel a warm glow all over me. Hold the phone, honey. I smell something burning.
Call you back, Darlene. My coat's on fire.
Well, I won't be able to wear that no more.
Oh.
morning, Ralph.
Mr. Wilson, I've checked and double-checked, and we don't have any income tax return from this Andrew H. Brown. That's his address right there.
Mr. Ignites of the Sea Lodge Hall at 138th Street. That's strange. I just ran across a George Stevens at that same address, who didn't file a return either. Bradshaw, you go over there and tell them that I want to see both of them right away.
Right, Chief.
Mr. Stevens is out the country. But just soon as he get back, I'll call your bill to his attention. Bye. And they closing in on me.
Hey, Kingfish, come over here.
I've been watching that fella out there.
He look like he coming in here all right, Andy. You think he's a bill collector?
I ain't sure, Kingfish. All I know is once I opened the door to a fella that looked like that, and the next thing I know, my furniture was gone. And I was looking on the floor like an Indian.
I thought I knew there was a bill collector in town. The only way I can figure this is that must be the replacement for Bulldog Jackson from the 147th Street Collection Agency.
Oh.
You know, Bulldog done jumped off a Brooklyn bridge 2 weeks after he got my account. And Andy, I ain't taking no chances. Lightning, there's a man coming in here, and if he's looking for me or Andy, we ain't here.
Yes.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I'd like to speak to Mr. Stevens and Mr. Brown.
They here.
Neither one of them?
No, sir.
Are you sure they are not here?
Oh, yes, sir. They told me so themselves.
Have them report to our office right away.
Yes.
And for their sake, I suggest they report to us immediately.
Yes, sir. I sure tell them all right.
I got to see you, sir.
Ralph R. Bradshaw, U.S. Bureau of Internal Revenue. Andy, this is one of the nastiest cards I've seen in a long time.
Bureau of Internal Revenue. Them the income tax people, ain't they?
Yeah, I wonder what they want us for. Wait a minute. He must meet out our tax. I wonder did he make out the thing right.
Well, let's ask him. Amos and Calhoun is across the hall in the large reading room working on some large business.
All right, come on, Andy.
So, Mr. Kingfish...
Oh, shut up, Lightning, and tend to your own business. Hiya, Calhoun. Hiya, Amos.
Hi,
oh,
fellas.
Oh, hi, fellas.
Say, Amos, there was a fella in here just now from the Income Tax Bureau.
Income Tax? See you again, fellas.
Calhoun, wait a minute. They ain't after you. They're looking for us.
Oh, looking for you.
Yeah, Amos, when you made out our income tax that month, did you do the thing right?
Why, certainly, fellas. There was no problem with yours.
Well, then what the man looking for us for?
Oh, I don't know. Well, let's say I did make a mistake in the addition or something, but that ain't nothing to worry about. All you have to do is pay a couple of dollars penalty and you're all right.
Well, I'm glad it ain't nothing more serious than that.
Yeah, well, it ain't, Andy, because
making a little mistake in arithmetic ain't nothing. The only time you was in trouble with them income tax boys is when you don't file no return at all. That's when they get Alcatraz. They can send you away for the rest of your natural life, or even longer.
Yeah, as far as we are concerned, we in the clear. Because we filed the returns, Amos made them out, and Andy mailed them. Yeah, so feel good.
It sure do. You know, for a minute there, I thought they was after me.
Well, all I know is that it can't be just as long, because I'm sure I made out the tax right.
It's funny how you can worry about something when there ain't nothing to worry about.
Yeah, well, that's how
it is. Looks like you got the apple quick there. Come on, some water, Calhoun. Good inspiration. I know you've got the stuff I'm from, please. But this is the only thing you hear.
Well, wait a minute. He's coming out of
it. How you feel, Andy?
You all right, Andy?
Yeah. I see you.
Don't doubt him, Calhoun. The boy's trying to say something. Andy, my pal. Friend of my childhood, Dave. What's wrong? What happened to you?
Kingfish, I done forgot to mail the income tax return.
You're dropping like flies.
Andy, I hope we get the same cell so I can beat your brains out.
My fault, Kingfish. The whole thing never would have happened if some gal hadn't come along wanting to breathe out.
Now, take it easy, fella.
Take it easy, nothing. Here, I've been a legal citizen for 40 years, and then this dummy inveigles me into a prison. A federal one at that.
Now, listen, fella. Listen to me. You're making this thing worse than it is. After all, mistakes like this must be made by some other people. And I figure the thing to do is just go up there and explain the thing honestly, and they ain't gonna put you in no jail.
They ain't, huh?
No, they might make you pay the back interest or some kind of penalty or something, and that's all.
Is you sure about that, Amos?
Why, certainly.
Amos, maybe you got something there. And for the first time in my life, I'm gonna take the bull by the horns, and I'm going up there and make a clean breast of it.
Yeah, well.
Hush up, you. We'll go up there.
You see, Mr. Wilson, I was mixed up in this automobile accident and wound up in the hospital, and naturally, I couldn't take care of anything.
Well, those things happen, Mr. Hansen. Now, there'll be a slight penalty on your delinquency, and we'll let you know what it amounts to.
Oh, yes, sir. I'll be very happy to pay it.
Oh, that is. Say, Kingfish, you think we're doing the right thing walking right into the lion's mouth?
Andy, Amos was right, eh? But one thing to do, and that's face the situation and go in there and tell the truth. How do you do there? We come up here to see about a tax matter.
Your names, please?
Well, this is Mr. Brown and I, Stevens.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Hansen. Yes?
A Mr. Brown and a Mr. Stevens to see you.
Oh, well, I have someone with me. Tell him I'll be with him in just a moment.
Mr. Wilson has someone with him at the moment, but he'll be through any minute now. Won't you sit down?
Thank you, ma'am. See, Andy? Somebody in there now would have done had tax trouble. Well, I guess it happened all the time.
Oh, yeah. After all, these people up here is reasonable. It ain't like that they's out to tear you apart if you make one little mistake.
It's a little hard for me. I wonder if you'd help me get my top coat over my shoulders.
Oh, pardon me, mister. But exactly what did you come up here for?
I was late in paying my tax.
Say, Kingfish, is hospital expenses deductible?
You heard what the man said, Andy.
Yeah, he was late paying his tax.
And we gonna be later than that. Come on, let's get out of here.
Just missed it.
You know, Andy, I just can't get it through my head that they would treat nobody like that.
Yeah, you wouldn't think they'd get that tough. After all, if they spent so much time tearing them apart, you don't think it'd waste so much time putting bandages on him, do you?
Well, Andy, maybe they're getting him in condition for the next time he delink.
Yeah.
You know, Andy, we may have misinterpreted this whole thing, and I think we're doing the wrong thing and running away. Look, Andy. There's a fella just went in. Andy, he mustn't get panicky about this thing. Come on.
Yeah.
Mr. Brown, Mr. Stevens, I believe you're next.
Oh, no, no. Take this gentleman first. We'll follow later.
All right. Would you come in, please?
Thanks very much.
I believe this thing's safe, Andy. If they mess that boy up, I going down on the elevator, rather that elevator there or not.
Yes? Oh, well, send him right up. I wonder if you'll pardon me for a moment, Mr. Fairchild. The armed guards are here for the tax collections we've received. I have to go get it for them. I'll be right back.
Perfectly all right.
Hey, Kingfish, what would them fellas want with them guns on their belts there?
I don't know, but I know this. They don't shoot no rabbits on the 14th floor.
Did Wilson say how long he'd be?
No, he said he'd just be a minute. I think he went out to get the collections for you.
Oh, I see. Hmm. You mind?
No, I like television.
This is that serial, Arizona Outlaw. Look at that fellow ride. I hope he gets there in time to save the mortgage.
There comes the villain.
You know, Andy, not that I worried anything, but I'd like to know what them two fellas with them guns on went in there for.
Yeah, me too. Maybe we can eavesdrop on them.
But it's only $6.
Yeah. It's only $6, but you owe it, and I'm going to get it.
Sound kind of tough for $6, don't you?
Put that gun down.
I'm not fooling.
You hear that, Kingfish?
A gun.
Oh, quiet, Andy. They're just trying to scam. They'd never use it for $6.
Don't cock that gun. It's only $6. I'm a married man. I got 3 children. I won't let you. Don't shoot. I won't let you.
And my tax was 19. Well, Andy, the way this outfit operates, you don't think they're going to gift wrap him, do you?
I'll be with you in a second.
With me in no second.
Me neither.
I don't mind giving my life for my country, but I ain't gonna do it for no $19. I get none.
What are we gonna do, Kingfish? They'll catch up with us sooner or later.
Andy, we got to get out of town right away and keep traveling.
Yeah, but where are we heading for?
I don't know, Andy, but we'll keep traveling and keep saying we're from New York. And when we meet somebody, say, where that? That's the place.
Yeah. Hey, look.
That's the fella we thought they shot.
Well, he look all right to me. But, Andy, maybe we're mistaken here or something. But let's don't take no chances.
Pardon. Thanks for coming up, Mr. Fairchild.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Hey, weren't you men waiting for me?
Yes, sir. But would you mind telling us... Mister, would you mind telling us what was in that sack that them two men with the guns carried through here just a minute ago?
Collections and official mail.
You hear that, Andy? Well, Andy, I guess there's no harm.
Won't you come in now? Tell me, why'd you gentlemen leave? Were you in a hurry or something?
Well, Mr. Wilson, it's a long story, and I'd like to go over the events of the past 10 minutes with you.
Certainly. Step right in. Well, that certainly is a funny group of circumstances. And although the consequences of not filing an income tax return aren't that serious, at the same time, it's not a laughing matter either.
Oh, no, son. Just like I say, we made out the return, and my friend here done forgot to mail them.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess that can happen.
Yes, sir. We'll make them out again and get the tax right over to you.
Yes, I'd advise you to do that right away, because failure to file a report can cause an awful lot of trouble and bring on some very serious repercussions.
Oh, yes, sir. We won't miss this time, and you will get the reports in a day or so.
I'm counting on that.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Good day. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good day.
There's one.
Well, there you is, Amos.
Well, this does it, fellas, again.
Yeah, thanks very much, Amos.
Yeah, I'll be glad when this mess is all over with. Give them to me, Amos, and I'll mail them right away.
Oh, no, you don't. You don't have to think I'm once called you, can't keep your mind on what you're doing.
Well,
Andy, I ain't taking no chances. I ain't the one who's going to mail them this time. Because when I got a job to do, I do it right.
All right, Kingfish, you take care of it.
Yeah, just as long as you get them to the Income Tax Bureau, you're all right.
Yeah, I'm going to get these in the mailbox right away. This is my lucky day.